Today, I will talk about our iSieve compressed earth block machine, where we got it from, how much it cost, how long it took to receive it, and other good and bad stuff of this machine. So hopefully this video helps someone considering alternative house build. So compressed earth block is made out of 90% of native soil and 10 to 15% of Portland cement and compressed it by either manpower or hydraulic to make blocks. Clay content supposed to be about 30% or so to be your best blocks, but as long as you stabilize it with the cement, it should be good. We're gonna do actual soil tests in the future, but I think our soil is good enough. No baking needed like traditional bricks, so it is more eco-friendly. No CO2 or carbon monoxide or any other pollutants are produced in the process of making them. The reason we decided to go with interlocking compressed earth block to build our off-grid house is because it's durable, fire, bullet, and soundproof. It can be pretty windy and then kind of eerie in the middle of the night in the Arizona desert. It is also creates thermal mass to regulate the inside temperature. My ideal temp all year round is 78 degrees and hoping that this thermal mass earth block is gonna create that temperature. Another reason that we are trying to do this is because there's not very many people doing it here in the United States, and there's not much YouTube video for that. There might be a reason, maybe it's just not worth doing it, but we are up for the challenge and hopefully you come along for this journey. So how we end up getting this particular machine is after hours of homework online, getting from out of a country was still cheaper than getting it here in the United States. There are a few companies in Texas like Dwell Earth and AECT, then their machine was pretty nice and it looks very efficient, but price was too high for us. So we got it from Alibaba.com about 3 years ago, and we spent total of $5,480, including custom and shipping. So the actual machine came to the door with that price. We chose hydraulic electric machine because there was a choice of diesel, but we have free electricity from our solar, so it was no brainer. Other choice we had was manual or automatic. To save our back, we chose automatic because the pressure on the block will be more consistent and we should be able to make better blocks this way. So the key to the successful ordering is clear communication with company. I think most of the company use a WhatsApp app. Get the company has warranty, guarantee, and money transaction insurance. This is definitely the final decision point that we went with this particular company. We also requested a video of the actual machine that we purchased making the blocks before they shipped that machine from China. And I'm gonna show this here that you can see machines making a beautiful blocks. And I'm assuming it is connected to power outlet there. And when we received our machine, there was no outlet connection. I'm assuming obviously China has different voltage and different outlet. So that was something that we were not aware of, that we have to make our own cable and outlet or connector for our US outlet. This is 30 amp machine, so we decided to use 3-prong RV connector with 00 cable. So far it is working, but Eric is suspecting the machine may be drawing more than 30 amp. So we might have to test it on our next trip. It took about almost 6 months or more from the start communicating with this company till the machine actually came to our doorstep. It was a long process, but we weren't any hurry to get this machine working, so we were not really worried about that at the time. packaging was a little bit mangled, frame and all that stuff, but machine itself came intact. We also purchased a half block mold. It was just a thin plate goes inside of the mold to cut it off our full block. And we thought we ordered easy interchangeable molds, but the mold is not really interchangeable like we thought. There are many different options, but if you want others, most likely you have to replace the majority of the unit because the mold is part of the machine. So just give you a heads up on that. We don't know much about this machine yet because last visit was our first time working with this machine. But even that, I felt like this machine was not quite thought through about the safety. There are a lot of areas are very dangerous. You could pinch your finger. So maybe we can fabricate some way to make it more safe. But this journey just started. Hopefully you guys can come along with us and hopefully we can make a dream house with this machine. I know it's gonna take a while because brick machine make two bricks at a time till we get hang of it. It's gonna take quite a bit to make each blocks. So people might be laughing at us by making that brick with these things, but why not? We kind of do something different, you know? So hopefully you enjoy coming along with our journey and hopefully you get inspired some way. Thank you so much for watching. You have a great day.